Hey gang, today we're going to do the solo to Journey's Lights with the great Neil Schon playing, or Neil Schon playing on guitar. Never know how to pronounce that. I always say Sean, but anyway, I digress. We're going to do that one, what I just played note for note, which I think is pretty close to what Neil played on the record. Okay, we're going to do the chordal play later in a lesson coming up pretty soon. But now we're just going to do the solo. All right. Well, as always, if you like this one, gang, give it the thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed for a couple of these every week, plus every Sunday, we do a live stream. It's lots of fun. Why don't you come and join us? Okay, coming up in just a few seconds. All right, gang, let's go over this note for note. First things first, you can download the tab from the link below in the description below. It's going to make your life a lot easier. Second thing is, let's just take a moment to go over the sound on this one. Because Neil Schon's sound on this is so unique, I think. And I did see him in concert. He plays this on a Strat in concert. At least he did the couple times that I saw him. So I'm doing the same thing. I'm playing it out of an S-style guitar. I'm playing out of the neck pickup to get some of those deeper tones. And I'm using sort of a classic amp with the gain cranked fairly high, but not super high. And maybe I'd say 8. So it's not 10, but it's pretty high. And then maybe 7. I don't know. And I've got some reverb on it and a little bit of delay and a decent amount of compression on this. All right, so that's what I've got going. Your mileage may vary. I don't claim by any stretch of the imagination to have nailed it completely. It is elusive, and he had an awesome sound back then. So anyway, that's what I'm doing. All right, let's now, what I'd like to do is I'd like to play the whole solo, and then we'll break it down line by line, okay? So it has this little opening part, and it's in the whoa, 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 whoa part of it. And it kind of goes like this. Whoa, 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 whoa. And then the solo starts. So that's the whole thing. Let's talk a little bit of theory before we start. I'm going to turn this down so I can play some of the chords. So this is played over under the bridge section, which the chords to that, we're going to do the full chords in a later lesson, including that cool intro. But anyway, the chords to that, the bridge section, are like the, it's sad, you know, that part right there. So anyway, it's B minor to G to D. You can die without you, B minor, G. Without your charms, D, A. B minor to G to D. Oh, and then B minor to C to D. All right. So all of those chords, every single one of them, fit into B minor, so, or D major, basically the same. You can think about either one you want to play. And so you can think about B minor pentatonic, playing that, or you can think about D major pentatonic, playing that. Everything except for the lines at the very end where he does this are in D major pentatonic. That part right there is in D minor pentatonic, as we'll see. All right, so let's kind of break down the whole thing. First of all, it's got this really cool intro. All right, for that one, we are going to definitely think of a D major pentatonic. And the timing on that is on the, like this, whoa, whoa, whoa. And on the last part where they go, whoa, that's when you do the, you know, you do that slide. And then we're going to walk up. Okay, so that is really just walking up the D major pentatonic scale. So we're starting out with this root note right here on a fifth string, fifth fret. And we're going to go 7, slide up to 9. Okay, and then walk up the D major pentatonic scale. So 7, 9 on the fourth. And then on the third, 7, 9. And this time we're going to slide up to the 11th. And then 10, 12 on the second. And 10, 12 on the first. Again, really slowly. Find the fingering that works for you. But that's it. Real nice way to kind of go all the way up there. All right, now here's the next line. Again, all in D major pentatonic. So we're going to bend a full step on the 12th on the first string. Come down and pull off to the 10th. And then, so we're ending on this very strong note on a D major that happens to be a D root on the first string on the 10th. So playing chord tones, always a strong idea, folks. All right, so there we go. That's the first part. And then we go the same thing. But this time we jump down to a chord tone down here, which is the second string, 10th fret. All right, so the whole thing put together is like this again. Okay, here's the second part. Okay, so pretty straightforward this. This is just straightforward blues, okay. So we're going to start out here with a classic bend and put it down. We're going to go on the D whole string, or whole step bend on the first string, 10th fret. And then come down and play it. Now here's a quick line. You got to play that really quick, okay. It's hard to play that quick. He plays it super quickly on the album. Okay, but that is just a standard blues lick, okay? So we're on the first string, we're playing 7, and this is just right out of the blues box. Right? The major pentatonic blues box on D. Okay, so we're playing 7, and then on second string, 10, pull off 7. And then on the third string, we're playing a very quick on the ninth. We're playing a full step bend, bring it down, and then pull it down to the off to the seventh, down to the fourth string, and back up. Okay, so give that lots of vibrato. He uses lots of vibrato on any stopping note that he's got. He puts a lot of vibrato on that. Okay? All right, so that's the first part, and then very simple. Very simple on the walking up the pentatonic on that, the major pentatonic on that. 7, hammer onto 9, and then 7, going to 9. And then we'll bend it up twice. Pull it off to 7, and then end up on the 9. Give it lots of vibrato, all right? Here's the whole line. Okay, there we go. Now we're going to come up to this. Let's play the next. The next line is the fast line, so we'll do that in and of itself. This is really simple but very effective. How cool is this line? This has always been my favorite. We're going to slide up, in the extended blues position. But again, remember, this is major pentatonic in D. All right, so on a 9th fret, 3rd string, we're going to slide up to 11. And then play 10, 12 on the 2nd. All right, and then we're going to just think about it this way. This is like a D chord, a tiny, tiny D chord, right? We're playing on a 10th fret on the 1st and 2nd string, and we're hammering on the 2nd string from the 10th to the 12th. Like so. And then we're going to hammer on and pull off and play on the 12th fret on the 3rd string. So I was saying it looks like a D chord, and it does, but this also looks like a mini G chord, doesn't it? All right, so there we go, D or G, really cool. If we played the D, we'd hammer off and come to here. That'd be a D. Anyway, if we end up on the G, that's a great note. Great, great, great. All right, let's go to the next line. This is the toughie that everybody has a problem with, but it's actually pretty simple once you get the basics down. It's really just a little finger exercise here in fourths. Okay, so we're just setting it up here on the 2nd string, 10th and 12th. And then what we're going to do is just play in fourths. So if you've ever studied fourths, they're just notes that are four notes away from each other in the scale that you're talking about. So for example, this in the D major scale, this would be 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? And then so would this. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4. So anyway, we're just going to go down that major pentatonic in fourths. And there's a number of different ways to play this. You know, I've seen it written like this. It's all fine. You know, I tend to play it in the same position. So that's what I'm going to show you. So we'll play on this, the first two strings, we're going to play 10 on the first and 10 on the second. Okay, and then come down to 7 on the first, 7 on the second. Now we're going to jump a string, okay? So we're going to go to the 2nd and 3rd strings and play 10 and 9. Okay? Then, still 2nd and 3rd strings, we'll play 7 and 7. All right, now we're going to go to the 3rd and 4th. And we're going to play 9 and 9 and 7 and 7. Now we're going to go to the 4th and 5th, and we're going to play 9 and 9. And 7 and 7. Now we're going to pretend that we're going to do it one more time, but we're just going to play the first note. So instead of playing, which would be the next part in the exercise, if we were doing an exercise, we just play the 9th and then wait. And then play. So that's a hammer on 7, 9, go to 7. All right, so let's do that whole thing again. Now practice that a bit and you'll get it up to speed. One thing I can tell you is I tend to like an upstroke on the higher string. So for example, when I'm playing this one right here on the first two strings at the 10th fret, I play an upstroke on the first string and a downstroke on the second. All right, and then I can repeat that. It's all the same, it's all two note pattern, so it all works the same. Right? And he just makes it cool by stopping a little bit. Come out of that with a neat little lick. Anyway, so there you go. That's something to practice over and over and to get it down. Okay, on to the next one. Now, he throws a little bit of a curveball and he switches over to the minor pentatonic scale and plays this. All right. Now, that may sound a little bit weird in this. It gives the solo just a tiny amount of hard edge, but if you see it, here's the D on the 10th fret, first string. So there's the minor pentatonic note. So he's not playing that regular box. He's using the extended box, or some people call it the, not quite the BB box. I've heard people say that, the Clapton box. Anyway, whatever. It's the little extension here. And so if... it's that one right there, okay? So we're going to play up on the 15th fret. And then a whole step bend on the 15th on the first string, pull off to the 13th. And 15 on the second. Give it lots of vibrato. And then again. But this time we're just going to stay on the first. All right, so that is playing the 13th. But you got to give it just a half step bend or so each, or a quarter step bend each time. Don't just play it straight. So if you play it straight, it's going to sound like this. That sounds okay, but definitely sounds cooler if you tweak it a little bit, like a blues player would. Neil Schon is an excellent blues player, so of course he tweaks it a bit. And let's give it a bit of vibrato, shall we? All right, so that's that line. That's now the last line is this. We're going to slide up to our D. So we're going to slide up and think about a D chord, a whole octave up from this D chord right here. We're all used to that one with the root on the fifth string, fifth fret, but we're going to pull it up a whole octave, right? And we're going to think about the top two strings here, all right? So let's pull it up a whole octave. All right, so that would be like this. Show it a little more clearly here. Now we're not going to play that whole chord. We're just going to play the top of the chord. That's how you visualize it, right? So we're going to play like this. So that's sliding up. I guess this is 17 to 19 on the second, and then 17 to 19 on the first. Okay, and then we're going to play our thing that we did before, but down here. Now we're going to play it for this chord. So I'm playing the first two strings on the 17th and hammering on the second to the 19th. And then, so for that, again, I'm playing a double stop here. But really, the action's all on the second string, and I'm playing this, 19, hammer on to 20, back to 19, and 17. And then 19, pull off to 17, play 19 on the third. And that, my friends, is that. That's the whole solo. Well, gang, there you have it. The solo to Journey's Lights. Just an absolutely fabulous solo. One of the all-time great solos, as far as I'm concerned. And, yeah, hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you next time. We're going to do the chords coming up soon. We'll see you down the road or something like that. Is that my tagline? I think so. All right, we'll see you on down the road.